Thank you, everybody. Nice to see you. We have a lot of interesting things to talk about, and we have some very specific things. So we'll take our time. We have plenty of time. I think you have plenty of time. I hope you like the weather. It's very nice. Nice place. Nice location. And I do thank you for being here. And we don't have very much heat. So I'd say it's perfect weather for this. The rain is not imminent based on the fact that there are no clouds. So it's really nice. It's really nice. And let's go over some big facts and some very substantial truths about where we stand as a country, because we're a failing nation because of the way it's been run for the last 3.5 years. We're a failing nation. People are coming into our country by the millions and millions and millions. We have no idea who they are, where they come from. But we're also a failing economy. Kamala Harris is a radical California liberal who broke the economy, broke the border, and broke the world, frankly. Very destructive to the entire world, because as we go, oftentimes the world goes. She destroys everything she touches. And if she wins, your finances and your country will never recover. You're never going to recover. A radical left person wants to put price controls all over the place, which will end up driving up your prices, not down your prices. Harris has just declared that tackling inflation will be a day one priority for her. It's going to be day one. But day one, really, for Kamala was 3.5 years ago. Where has she been? And why hasn't she done it? Why hasn't she done it? I hear her complaining all the time. She was the border czar, but she didn't do anything. It's the worst border czar in history. There's never been a border czar so bad. She's been unbelievable in terms of her badness to some of our allies, some of our great allies. You know who I'm talking about. Here is the record of economic calamity that Kamala is desperate for voters to ignore. She cast the tie-breaking votes that caused record inflation. She cast the votes. She's trying to blame Biden, as you know. So it was Biden, but I'm going to do a better job. But it was her. And if she wants to do a better job, she's still got 5 months left, right? But she can't do a better job because she doesn't know how to. And she's of a place in life where she wouldn't know what a better job is. Going to destroy our country. And as a result of Kamala's inflation price hikes, they've cost a typical household a total of $28,000. These are numbers coming from government. They're not coming from me. $28,000 she's cost the typical household. Kamala's inflation nightmare continues to cost the average American family $1,100 every single month. $1,100. Again, government numbers. You're paying $148 more a month on food. That's every month. Average family, because Kamala and her ideas, and Joe Biden, too. I mentioned him, but he's sort of gonzo. It all started with the debate. I should have been a little bit easier. Somebody said, your debate performance was horrible. I said, why? Because you forced him out of government. But I believe she'll be just as bad. I believe she's maybe in many ways going to be worse, because he wasn't really a radical left. But she is. She's real. He wasn't real. So I think she's going to be, in many ways, easier to beat than Joe Biden. What they did to him was disgraceful, by the way. And it really is a threat to democracy. It was a coup by people that wanted him out. And they didn't do not the way they're supposed to do it. $129 more on energy and $241 more. This is all per month on rent. So you have that, $148, $129, $241, and then many other increases. You add it all up. It's thousands and thousands of dollars that she and he have cost people. The cost of a typical monthly mortgage has doubled since I left office, and that number was about 3 months old from government, and now it's tripled. We had mortgage rates at around 2%, close to 2%, and they're now at 10%, and you can't get a mortgage. So that means it's a lot higher than 10%. I guess it is whenever they want to give over the money, and that's a lot more than 10%. So when you think about double, they've actually quadrupled or more than that. Think of that, quadrupled, which really kills the American dream for young people. Young people are being devastated by what they've done to our country. Grocery prices have skyrocketed. Cereals are up 26%. Bread is up 24%. Butter is up 37%. Baby formula is up 30%. Flour is up 38%. And eggs are up 46%. And many items are up at much higher rates than that. Now Kamala is reportedly proposing communist price controls. She wants price controls. And if they worked, I'd go along with it, too. But they don't work. They actually have the exact opposite impact and effect. But it leads to food shortages, rationing, hunger, dramatically more inflation. Their Inflation Reduction Act, by the way, was a disaster. It's what caused the inflation. Their Inflation Reduction Act was a con job. They actually admitted that it wasn't really for inflation that they did it. They don't know why they did it, but they named it the Inflation Reduction Act, which was a very nice name. Got approved based on that. Unfortunately, people didn't understand it. I understood it. I said, that's going to cause tremendous inflation, and it did, among other things, like energy. She's running on the Maduro plan. We call it the Maduro plan, like something straight out of Venezuela or the Soviet Union. This announcement is an admission that her economic policies have totally failed and caused really a catastrophe for our country, and beyond that, a catastrophe in the world. A little bit unrelated, but not totally unrelated. We have wars breaking out in the Middle East. We have the horrible war going on with Ukraine and Russia. All these things would have never happened if I was president. Would have never, ever happened. And they didn't happen. Since Harris took office, car insurance is up 55%, and they just announced it's going to be substantially higher than that within the next week. They expect big increases in car insurance. It's out of control, and insurance generally. Thanks to Kamala's war on American energy, electricity prices are up 32%. Gasoline prices are up 50% and going higher. Meanwhile, real incomes are down by over $2,000 a year. So the incomes for people are down $2,000 on average a year, government numbers. The typical American has seen a 4% pay cut under Kamala and Biden. Crooked Joe Biden. Credit card debt has exploded by 50% under Harris to a record high. It's now at a record high. It's never been anywhere close. Since March, and by the way, people are going to have to start paying that, and it's not going to be a pretty sight for the next period of time. It could be a substantial time. Since March of 2022, the average middle class household has lost $33,000 in wealth. How about that? $33,000. That's average. In July alone, 350,000 people were added to the unemployment rolls. It's a lot of people. 350,000 people added to the unemployment rolls. And think of that. That's in 1 month. That's in July. Virtually 100% of the net job creation in the last year has gone to migrants. You know that? Most of the job creation has gone to migrants. In fact, I've heard that substantially more than beyond the number of 100%. It's a much higher number than that, but the government hasn't caught up with that yet. But virtually right now, as of the time they did this, virtually 100% of the net job creation in the last year has gone to migrants. Harris gave work permits and Social Security numbers to more than 3 million illegal immigrants to steal jobs from Americans. So think of that. And, you know, they're having a lot of problems with Social Security. I'm going to be the one to save Social Security, but they're having a lot of problems with Social Security because under their system of putting all of these people into it, it's going to blow up and fail. If she's elected, Social Security will fail. It'll be a blow up like you've never seen before. It'll be a bankruptcy of the entire system, probably the nation itself. You don't have to imagine what a Kamala Harris presidency would be, because you're living through that nightmare right now, and it is a nightmare. It's a nightmare. And you're going to stop inflation, but we're going to have a crash, and we're going to have a crash like a 1929 crash if she gets in. You saw a gentleman yesterday who got up, one of the top analysts in the world, frankly, and said that if Trump isn't elected, he predicts, and he's predicting you'll have a stock market crash like 1929. He also said the only time and the only reason the stock market has gone up, even though it had some bad moments recently. But I think we'll take a substantial lead. You saw the polls come out today. We're leading in most of the polls, but you'll have a...